Okay, big question here from Alec. There is a very basic mistake in how Darwin's theory is quoted, survival of the fittest. What does it mean? The common way it is used means the strongest will triumph. This is definitely not the idea of Darwin's theory. It has three underlying principles. There is an excess of individuals born to a species than that are required for simple replacement. Individuals within species vary in traits that may be inherited and, brackets, I think, that individuals, due to inherent traits, have variability in their ability to thrive in the environment. Fitness, in Darwin's terms, is then that the individual to survive is the one most fit for their environment. Giraffes are very tall and fit to exploit high vegetation. Sheep crop grass very short. They are fit to exploit exceptionally short feed. This is fitness and has nothing, brackets typically, to do with physical strength. So that the special trait in humans that has made them super survivors, humans are not fast, humans are not large, humans are not very tough, humans as a species are not particularly fit, brackets tough, in just about everything. The trait in which humans have excelled is sociability, cooperativeness, the willingness to form groups, brackets tribes, that can hunt collectively, look after the injured, raise children without each mother having to chase tigers instead of looking for baby food, etc. This is our magic trait, our willingness not just to support each other, but to risk dying to protect the tribe and its infants. The term fitness, to mean brutishness, is mostly promoted by either those who wish to enforce their will on others or those that who are scared of those people. It is beyond time that we embrace our fitness, our community bonding, and stop blaming Darwin for the misunderstanding. What are your thoughts, Geoff? Okay, well, Alec, I'm all with you. Fitness actually can be looked at as connectivity. The survival of the most connected, which means the ones that fit into diversity. Diversity is the strength of ecosystems. Elements that fit together because they perform more than one function, and every function supported by more than one element gives you this strong web of life. We as humans are potentially designers of this system. Our brain function, as extended to writing and reading and numbers and mathematics, we're at the point of understanding how we can be the ultimate connective design discipline science element. It's the science of connectivity, which is the way you interpret it in your question, the way we fit things together, fitness in that term. So that is survival. And that is survival for all species. And right at the moment, we're well and truly out of order when it comes to making connections. We're reducing connections. We're simplifying things. We're quantifying and percentifying everything. We have a reductionist science view of things. We need to understand that we'll never understand all things. Just the complexity of life in the soil is well beyond our understanding. And it's just about infinite. So welcome to infinity. Once you become comfortable with this, then you become a better designer, someone who has eyes that can see more of what needs to be seen to design this system. It's about not necessarily thinking through every single component, but looking at the possibilities of facilitating a life-rich event, which is going to express its own evolutions, which we then continue to observe. So, welcome aboard. And it's going to be an interesting journey as we go through this.